Well, this is a Kwaai day at the top of Table Mountain as we're contemplating the year ahead of us, the year of artificial intelligence. But we're immersed in reality. This is what's real. Real rocks, real sky, real sea, real land, and real people. When I grew up in this town, it was at the height of apartheid, a dark time in this country's history. The fate of this nation is analogous to the fate of the entire global predicament we're in. Forces that drive the increasing monopolization of power and wealth are those forces that also increase the gap between rich and poor. It's vitally important that we mobilize rather than moan, that we organize rather than writing passive blogs about the dire situation we're in. It's not just artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence is not a new phenomenon. It's an extra tool in the hand of capitalism to continually concentrate wealth amongst very few individuals. What is called for is an altruistic intervention, a movement of volunteers, a democratization of artificial intelligence. South Africa underwent a move towards democracy, set them on a path to right the wrongs of the past, and there's no going back. In the area of artificial intelligence, we have a similar phenomenon, this trend of monopolization. An oligopoly controls the industry. It's our thesis that every consumer, every user has to own their own artificial intelligence, own and operate it themselves. This very issue has been playing out in the Hollywood actors and writers strikes. But let's take healthcare as an example. Your digital twin, my digital twin, is now owned by several different healthcare providers. My financial habits are also owned by other multiple service providers. My travel habits. What we assert is that each user should own their own AI. We'll give them the tools to be able to own and control and manage their own digital twin, their own artificial intelligence, and they would be able to negotiate, or they'd be able to expose the amount of information they want to each service provider for them to gain access. So turning the whole model on its head, rather than service operators, service providers having to glean your likes and dislikes, you can tell them. You will have your own co-pilot that will be able to engage with third-party systems in an automated way and would act on your behalf. It'll free you up, for instance, from your email inbox and handle your incoming emails for you. Automation is coming. Co-pilots are coming. Some of them are here already. What is vitally important is that you own your own co-pilot. If you don't, you are in effect giving up the pilot seat. Own your own co-pilot. Let it accelerate and amplify your capability and improve your employability. Our organization is called Kwaai. It comes from the street parlance of this very town. It means cool, it means angry, it has nuanced and complicated intentions and meanings. It's our mission to create tools to allow you to own your own AI and manage it. Kwaai is a non-profit, volunteer-based, open-source developer community. It's a technical think tank and it's a policy think tank. We have technical work groups building open source software, policy work groups creating legal language, creating licensing agreements and creating the sort of certification and nutrition facts that every single AI model should have. So Kwaai is in its infancy. We started in 2023. 2024 is the year in which we amplify it and we grow Kwaai. It's important that you join. If you are an AI thinker, you might want to volunteer. You'd be curious, you'd be eager to contribute to an international collaboration. You'll be involved in perhaps writing software, perhaps writing technical papers, perhaps contributing to publications. Come and join us. Join the movement. Join the movement that is democratizing AI. Thank you.